Methylene blue has been getting an awful lot of attention for being an anti-aging compound and all-around health elixir. Let's look at the actual proof for methylene blue to help you decide if it's right for you. So first off, what is methylene blue? It's actually a synthetic dye that was invented in 1876 and used in the textile industry. Methylene blue also holds a special place in the medical world because it was the very first synthetic drug used to treat malaria. And this practice actually continued for several decades, all the way through World War II. These days, the FDA has just one authorized use for this dye, and that is to treat methemoglobinemia, which is a condition where the hemoglobin molecules of your red blood cells don't carry oxygen as well as they should. Even though methylene blue is well over a century old, this doesn't stop the number of clinical papers being published on this dye, with over 30,000 alone being on the National Library of Medicine the last time I checked. So what does this research tell us about methylene blue's role in aging, cellular health, mitochondria, and many other things? And equally important, what are the potential side effects of methylene blue if you're going to try this for yourself? So let's begin by talking about the mitochondria. The mitochondria are essentially tiny little batteries in your cells that help us turn food into energy. And while they are extremely important, the mitochondria are also the primary source of reactive oxygen species, which cause free radical damage, also called oxidative stress. The other interesting thing here is that the mitochondria are increasingly seen as a source of long-term disease and disability, ranging from kidney disease, heart disease, diabetes, and even maybe the aging process too. Now, methylene blue has antioxidant properties, so what does this mean for mitochondrial health and long-term disease and disability? Right now, there's an awful lot of animal and cell-based research indicating that methylene blue plays a role in mitochondrial health, but to date, the human-based research is actually quite limited. For example, I uncovered no research which compared the mitochondrial benefits of methylene blue to that of exercise, which is well known to improve not only mitochondrial health, but the size and number of mitochondria too. And that's weird because this would be something that's relatively easy to test. What about kidney health? In this paper, researchers wanted to see if methylene blue could reduce kidney damage. The participants here were 9 septic shock patients who received a 4-hour infusion of methylene blue. The good news, methylene blue reduced markers of kidney damage. It also reduced the urinary excretion of nitric oxide metabolic byproducts by as much as 90% as well. And that's interesting because while nitric oxide is usually seen as a good thing, its production in sepsis becomes dysregulated and it's thought to play a role in kidney injury and kidney failure. They also report that methylene blue improved the clearance of creatinine by as much as 51%. This suggests that the dye may have an effect on glomerular filtration rate, which is a measure of kidney function. I want to point out that while it is good that creatinine levels did decrease, they did not return to normal. In other words, overall kidney function was not improved for methylene blue. And the saddest part of all, unfortunately, is that 7 of the 9 people in this study passed away within a month. In other words, methylene blue didn't help these people live any longer. So what about the antiviral effects of methylene blue? We actually have some very interesting papers here. In this study, which was published in 1973, 18 out of 20 herpes simplex patients, 90%, experienced symptom relief after applying light activated methylene blue to their affected areas. When they followed up with these people between 18 and 30 months later, it was revealed that 85% of those patients reported fewer outbreaks, with some people seeing as much as a 50% reduction in flare-ups. There's also this paper, which was published in 1975, involving 35 people with herpes simplex, where methylene blue was applied topically to the affected areas and then exposed to a light source. Results here showed that while methylene blue did improve symptoms, it did not significantly reduce the frequency of outbreaks. Now let's turn our attention to methylene blue's effect on depression, and we actually have some interesting papers here. And one of the reasons for this is that methylene blue inhibits an enzyme called monoamine oxidase. Monoamine oxidase is an enzyme that breaks down serotonin, dopamine, and norepinephrine levels. And here's where things get interesting, because some antidepressant medications also work by inhibiting the monoamine oxidase enzyme. So this then begs the question, can methylene blue help depression? So we have this study, which lasted 3 weeks and involves 35 women described as having severe depression. Methylene blue is said to be a potent antidepressant compared to those who took placebos. And it's further stated that the benefits started to manifest themselves after only 1 week. Here's another study which lasted 2 years and involved 31 people with bipolar disorder who were given two different dosages of methylene blue daily. It's reported here that the higher dose of methylene blue actually improved depression symptoms. However, neither dose had any effect on manic episodes. So pretty interesting results. However, I want to caution you that you really want to speak to your doctor and pharmacist before you start experimenting on yourself with methylene blue. And that's because it could have a serious interaction with antidepressant medications that you may be taking. We're going to talk more about that later in the video. Methylene blue may also be promoted as a memory booster. And one of the ways it's thought to help the brain is through its actions on the mitochondria of brain cells. At low doses, methylene blue is thought to work on the electron transport chain in the mitochondria to help the mitochondria make energy more efficiently, while at the same time reducing those reactive oxygen species which cause free radical damage. Sounds plausible. Well, what's the proof? Well, we have this paper involving 26 men and women who were given a single dose of oral methylene blue, and then they had their short-term memory tested while they were using a functional MRI machine. Those taking methylene blue saw about a 7% improvement in short-term memory compared to those people who took placebos. And that's really interesting. However, I want to point out that only 6 of the 30 people in this investigation were over the age of 30. What I'm getting at here is this study alone can't prove that methylene blue improves memory in older folks who may be suffering memory deficits. But we're not done yet, because we actually have this larger trial involving 321 people with mild to moderate Alzheimer's disease. They're given 3 different amounts of oral methylene blue or a placebo, and this study lasts for 2 years. Results here are pretty interesting. The individuals who had mild Alzheimer's disease who took the methylene blue, they actually had better blood flow to the brain. Equally interesting is that in the individuals with moderate Alzheimer's disease, methylene blue helped them get a 5-point higher score on Alzheimer's tests compared to those individuals who took placebos. Now let's switch gears and talk about methylene blue and cancer. So we have this paper showing that an oral rinse solution of methylene blue reduced pain in the mouths of people who had mouth sores caused by radiation therapy. There's also this study of 17 people with basal cell carcinoma skin cancer showing that topical methylene blue applied to the skin and activated with light appeared to make skin cancer not detectable in about 80% of those individuals. We also have this review of 10 previous investigations indicating that methylene blue might be effective for a variety of cancers ranging from colorectal cancer to breast cancer and several others. And while that's good news, be aware that this paper is actually reviewing a variety of studies where animals were infused with methylene blue, which is very different than the way this dye is being marketed to the general population. In other words, right now, there's very little evidence that taking methylene blue orally as a supplement would benefit people who have cancer. Methylene blue may also be promoted for slowing the aging process and extending lifespan too. So what is the proof for this? In this study, researchers tested methylene blue on fibroblast cells. These are cells that produce collagen and elastin, and they took the cells from both healthy people and those who had progeria. Progeria is a very rare genetic condition which causes accelerated aging. Results showed that methylene blue actually reduced oxidative stress in those skin cells, and it worked better than other antioxidants, including N-acetylcysteine and mito-Q. It also increased the NRF2 antioxidant defense pathway too. Collagen and elastin production improved in both healthy cells and those from progeria patients as well. And as an added bonus, the cells from people with progeria, those cells lived longer too. So pretty interesting results. And based on the increase in collagen and elastin formation, I would not be surprised if methylene blue started showing up in anti-wrinkle formulas. However, be aware that just because something increases collagen and elastin production did not necessarily mean it erases fine lines and wrinkles. When in doubt, do your research and ask companies to show you before and after pictures. And while we're talking about aging, I also wanted to show you this paper where methylene blue failed to prevent bone loss or improve bone structure in old mice that were treated with methylene blue for up to 18 months. Now, because this is a mouse study, it doesn't necessarily mean methylene blue wouldn't have a beneficial effect on the bones of humans, but like a lot of things when it comes to methylene blue research, We just need better studies. Now, if you're going to experiment with methylene blue, you need to be aware of the potential side effects. This is something I don't see a lot of people talking about, so let's look at some of these side effects now. Common side effects from methylene blue can include nausea, diarrhea, dizziness, falls, and even painful or uncomfortable urination. Mild burning in the mouth when used as an oral rinse has also been reported. Your urine or skin may change color, looking either blue or bluish green. And this side effect may actually happen fairly quickly, from a few hours to a couple days after you start taking methylene blue. Methylene blue may interact with some laboratory tests, such as, for instance, making it look like you have protein in your urine when you really don't. It may interfere with oxygen saturation tests, as well as blood sugar and many other tests as well. So if you're going to try this for yourself, you really want to tell your doctor, and also stop taking methylene blue at least 2 weeks before you have any kind of testing done. Even though methylene blue is often promoted as being an antioxidant, understand that at high doses, it can actually have the opposite effect and become pro-oxidant. And as for what constitutes a high dose, if you're using this as an eyedropper and putting some drops on your tongue, well, that also requires more study too. Who should not use methylene blue? The first group that comes to mind is any woman who is pregnant or breastfeeding. There's no research on methylene blue as it's being promoted to the general public today, and its effects on pregnancy, fetal growth, and nursing. However, there is some evidence from the medical world suggesting that methylene blue may not be safe for developing babies. Another group that should avoid methylene blue is anyone with a genetic condition called glucose-6-phosphate dehydrogenase deficiency. In people who have this condition, methylene blue may actually cause the destruction of your red blood cells. Exercise caution if you have high blood pressure. Methylene blue inhibits the production of nitric oxide. This can lead to constriction of your blood vessels and an increase in your blood pressure. This same caution goes out to anyone who has kidney disease or kidney failure. Not only do the kidneys play a role in blood pressure, but methylene blue can also inhibit the blood flow to the kidneys as well. Methylene blue has the potential to interact with antidepressant medications, causing serotonin levels to go dangerously high. This can cause a condition called serotonin syndrome. You cannot sugarcoat how serious serotonin syndrome is. Your blood pressure can go dangerously high, and you would probably require hospitalization. And for this same reason, you want to be very cautious with dietary supplements touted to raise serotonin levels too. This includes tryptophan, 5-HTP, and St. John's wort, among others. Also be very careful if you have Parkinson's disease. The same enzyme that breaks down serotonin also breaks down dopamine. And in theory, methylene blue may cause dopamine levels to go higher than they should, resulting in a worsening of Parkinson's disease symptoms. Since I started speaking about the potential side effects of methylene blue, people have told me they have also experienced side effects, including elevated blood pressure, tremors, and one person even told me he had a stroke. Now, those are testimonials, and you can do with them as you like, but the very research itself tells us that we have a long way to go before we can prove or disprove all the miraculous things that social media influencers are telling us about methylene blue. My advice, be careful and wait for better proof.